fabulous executive living bordering Oak Mountain State Park. Colleen and David Black, Keller Williams Realty, 356-5412. Call on Colleen.
This is the Weather Extreme video, direct from Mount Cheeha. I'm meteorologist Brian Peters with you on this Sunday, June 7th edition. And let's get right to some sky cams. Well, you can see one sky cam behind me. Let's take a look at Demopolis this morning and a little bit of cirrus clouds. The river rather flat. Towboat's not there this morning like it was yesterday. And here's the sky cam image from Mount Cheeha. And you can see just a few clouds out there. Just a little bit of early morning buildups to the moisture that's in the lowest part of the atmosphere. On the surface map this morning, we have a little surface low along the Georgia-South Carolina coastline and the frontal system across the central U.S. with a low pressure surface, low pressure area there, and that's where a lot of the action is for severe weather for today. Little upper level low, even though the trough is moving off the east coast, a little upper level low over the southeast coast of the United States, but the main action is in the central plain states. Just a little bit warmer this morning. We were in the 50s yesterday morning. We're in the middle 60s for the most part, although a few locations probably have dipped into the upper 50s this morning. QPF wise, just like we saw yesterday, not much precipitation is in store for Alabama for the next week or so. And as I mentioned, the main threat for severe weather with a moderate risk for parts of Missouri and Nebraska and Kansas and just a little bit of southwestern Iowa there, surrounded by a larger slight risk area that extends from Chicago down to a little bit northwest of Oklahoma City. And that is where the main action will be for much of the next several days. Just a little bit of action in the tropics, not a very well-organized area. We can see from the satellite imagery just a bit of a disturbed area there in the southwestern Caribbean. All right, let's get to the 06Z GFS model run. And no, we don't have a great deal to talk about. We can see the ridge building in at 500 millibars. This is the Monday forecast for midday. And for Tuesday, you can see the ridge seems to get just a little bit stronger, so I think we're going to stay dry through Tuesday. You know, I can't rule out the possibility of an isolated shower, but I think pretty much dry. By Wednesday, the ridge looks like it's still just as strong, but it's beginning to show a little bit of signs of weakening with the westerlies just to the north. By Thursday, that ridge has weakened just a little bit as those westerlies push a little further south, but not enough really to get more than a front down into the Ohio and perhaps approaching the Tennessee River valleys. By Friday, the ridge has flattened out. And that's okay. We'll probably see a few showers, and we still have that frontal zone just to our north, but not getting down into the Tennessee River Valley exactly, but getting close. The ridge remains somewhat flat on Saturday, and of course that will mean that we have the possibility of some isolated to scattered showers. And then on Sunday, it looks like still the possibility with that frontal system there and a little surface low scooting by up over the eastern Great Lakes. And by Monday, the ridge is beginning to show signs of building back in again. But not quite as strong as what the GFS showed yesterday. And then out in Voodoo just a little bit, and yeah, it's not as strong as what the GFS was showing yesterday, but by the 21st of June, the ridge is certainly in there fairly strong, and that means pretty much just the diurnal, the daily showers, and possible thunderstorms in the afternoons and early evenings. Well, I'm meteorologist Brian Peters. Thanks for tuning in. James is going to be on vacation this coming week, so I expect to have Weather Extreme videos posted by around 8 o'clock or so. I'm not quite the early riser that he is. In the meantime, Godspeed.